The West End has a long and fascinating history. It is a great city packed with arts and culture. In this documentary, we will take a trip back in time to discover how different time periods in our colourful history have influenced the theatre we see in the West End today. We begin in the 17th century, when the first professional theatres are established in London. The Jacobean era, the period between 1603 and 1625, saw the emergence of some of the greatest theatrical works of all time. During this time, William Shakespeare wrote some of the most celebrated plays in history.
I think Shakespeare's amazing. It is that kind of, it's a funny one. For me, the thing that excites me most about Shakespeare and the thing that I find most interesting about Shakespeare is when we say Shakespeare, a lot of people will turn up their noses, but it is a bit heightened. It is really, really freaking clever, but I think it's amazing. And I think it's made such an impact on British culture, the way that we interact and theatre culture. And as you could say, without Shakespeare, would the West End be what it is today?
The theatre during the Jacobean era was marked by a few distinctive trends. The plays were darker and more pessimistic than they had been in the Elizabethan era, and the language used was more complex and ornate. There was a greater emphasis on revenge tragedies, and the plays often featured complex plots and a heavy focus on political themes. Aside from the development of theatre, the Jacobean era was also a time of great political change. King James I was a patron of the arts, and he was heavily involved in the development of literature and theatre. The court of King James I was a major centre of cultural activity, and plays were often performed for the court. The work of William Shakespeare was a major influence on the theatre of the Jacobean era. Shakespeare wrote some of his greatest tragedies during this period, including Macbeth, Hamlet, and King Lear. His plays often featured complex themes, such as the struggle between good and evil, and the danger of ambition. It was also a time of great political and religious change, and the plays of the era often reflected this. The theatre of the Jacobean era is an important part of history and literature, and continues to influence the modern day theatre today. By 1800, there were not enough theatres in London for the fast-growing population of theatre lovers. There were two winter theatres, which are indoor theatres, Covent Garden and Drury Lane. The development of the modern West End Theatre District began in the early 19th century, with the rise in popularity of the Theatre Royal Drury Lane. This theatre was one of the first to be built in the area, and soon, the building of other theatres began to follow. By the mid-19th century, several theatres had been built in the area, including the Lyceum Theatre, the Haymarket Theatre, and the Adelphi Theatre, originally called the Sans-Pareil. The most popular form of theatre at the time was vaudeville theatre. Vaudeville consisted of many different forms of entertainment, each performance lasting around 15 minutes. The audience would not mind waiting for the next performance, knowing they would likely see something they could enjoy. The Vaudeville Theatre in London held most of the vaudeville performances that happened in London. It opened in 1870, however, it was rebuilt twice, incorporating the old building into the new. Before having big names such as Andrew Lloyd Webber and Lin-Manuel Miranda being the faces of the performing arts industry, music hall stars were the celebrities of their day. The audiences wanted to see their favourite stars performing the songs and routines that they were well known for, and so scripts had to be adapted to create a well-rounded show for audiences. Edging closer to the 20th century, the Lyric and the Garrick Theatre were built in 1866.
So my experience in the performing arts industry has been very vast. I started as a performer, trained at Lane Theatre Arts in Epsom, went on tour with West Side Story into the West End, then did tours with Wayne Sleep, I was in a show called Anything Goes on tour as well, a couple of pantomimes, then decided that I'd open a college. So I started a performing arts college in Guildford called PPA College, which is still going now. So I was one of the original founders. And then Epsom Stagecoach came up for sale and I bought that, and the rest has been history.
Jumping forward into the mid-1900s, we see plays such as An Inspector Calls making its British premiere. This play has gone on to be hugely successful and is taught in secondary schools up and down the country. We also see The Mousetrap open at the Ambassadors Theatre in 1952 and is now in its 71st year in the West End. The mid to late 20th century saw huge development in London theatre. World famous shows open in the theatre district, such as Les Miserables and The Phantom of the Opera, which have stood the test of time and are still extremely popular today.
The performing arts industry is ever evolving and ever changing, and it's changed so much already, even from when I was in the industry. And it's changed in a lot of really good ways.
But because it's a business, it's quite rare for the industry to take risks on things. So you've had musicals that have been going for well over a decade, and you're kind of, and there's just a part of me that's like, oh, wouldn't it be nice if some of this beautiful new British musical theatre, it'd be great if that could be on in these spaces.
Body image is not so much of an issue. You know, you don't have to be tiny to get into a show. There's so many more opportunities for people with disabilities. And I think that's actually fantastic across TV screen and theatre. I think where I'd like to see more changes would be actually more in schools and in education. I think drama and singing and performing arts has so much to offer children in general. So I'd love to see it more as part of the curriculum in more schools around the country.
We also start to see the rise of films being adapted into musicals, specifically jukebox musicals. These productions have something for everyone and are extremely accessible to the public, unlike the performances that were put on in the 1800s, which were targeted to the bourgeoisie. Popular jukebox musicals on the West End now are Mamma Mia, Moulin Rouge, Tina the Musical and We Will Rock You. In recent years, West End shows have become much more spectacular than ever before. We are seeing incredible sets, lighting, costumes and visual effects that weren't possible until very recently. A modern West End musical is truly an art form in itself. The West End has been home to some of the most successful musicals of all time, including Wicked and Cats. These musicals have been seen by millions of people around the world and have won numerous awards.
I think it's really important that young people know the history of West End theatres. In fact, I'm always asking my students, who wrote that show? Who composed that show? What theatre is that show on at? Because if you're going to do it as a career, you really do need to know the industry, as well as knowing about the shows and the history of the shows and the industry in general.
Many of the plays and musicals that are performed in the West End are also performed on Broadway in New York. Today, the West End is still an epicentre for creative arts and continues to produce some of the best plays, musicals and performances in the world. It is a vibrant and exciting area that is full of history and culture. We have explored the Jacobean era and its dark plays and famous playwrights, heard from experts on what working in the West End is really like, how the industry is becoming more inclusive and welcoming to everyone, and why we should support the performing arts. We have delved into the 1800s and the building of many of the West End's theatres, and looked at how performances have developed into the incredible productions that are available for us in 2023, and how they are created to spread love, passion, and joy for an ever-changing industry.